People often ask me, what exactly is the study of honey? Well, we call it melissopalynology. Now, melissio means sweet, and palynology means pollen. So it's really the study of pollen in sweet things, or the study of pollen in honey. Every year, we hear that in Turkey, a few individuals actually end up in the hospital because they have OD'd on mad honey. The reason it's called mad honey is because if you eat this stuff, a certain alkaloid by the name of gonoxotoxin actually can cause you tremendous disorientation, hallucinations, and very low blood pressure, which could lead to some serious health problems. Well, mad honey is created by the little bees that go to rhododendron plants in the area right around the Black Sea. And these rhododendron plants just happen to produce this very toxic alkaloid, which the bees take up in the nectar. They then incorporate this into the honey. Now, it doesn't affect the bees at all. It only affects the individuals that end up eating the honey. We have Pompey the Great, a great Roman general who was chasing the Persians back to Iran. The Persians had read about Xenophon's honey, so they purposely confiscated a lot of honey in that area, purposely left it in large pots on the road. The Romans naturally stopped, ate all the honey. The next morning, the Persians descended on them. The Romans were so disoriented, they could no longer fight. The only reason I know so much about mad honey is because Texas A&M is the only place in the United States that actually analyzes honey. We get honey from all over the world that they want analyzed here, including stuff that comes from Turkey. I use honey, sometimes put it in my drinks, sometimes put it on my cereal. I use it in cooking and everything, but I try to stay away from the mad honey. I've never actually tested mad honey. I take their word for it.